نحن لن نستسلم، ننتصر أو نموت.
أضحى الإسلام لنا دينا وجميع الكون لنا وطنا.
الله الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمد الله سبحانه حمدا عباده الشاكرين، ونصلي ونسلم على رسولنا الكريم صلى الله عليه وسلم. أما بعد، it's no secret that Fajr prayers is difficult for many to establish on time. Fajr prayers comes at the prescribed time when sleeping is at its peak and everyone feels warm and snuggly in their comfortable beds under their blankets. There is no alternative to this. A Muslim must establish prayers on its prescribed time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained upon the believers. First of all, the one that created man, subhanahu, is he not Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim, Al-Hakim, Al-Adl, Al-Alim, Al-Sami' Al-Basir, subhanahu, Alla ya'lamu min khalaqa wa huwa al-latif al-khabir. Does he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, know what he has created? And he is the subtle one and all-knowing? We need to make our worldly life and daily routines work around our religious duties towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not the other way around. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commandments should be priority in our lives. Everything else comes second to this. We were created for this sole purpose. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لَيَعْبُدُونَ. I have not created jinn and humans except to worship me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَجَعَلْنَا النَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. And we made the night as a covering for you and made the day for your livelihood. It's enough for your creator subhanahu wa ta'ala to tell you what is good or bad for you. I would like to make a note here. At night we sleep with the lights off, of course, and that signals the brain, in specific your pineal gland, to produce a hormone called melatonin. And this hormone is responsible for helping you feel good and happy and energetic throughout your day. And in our day and age, majority of the people sleep very late, having to wake up early for their worldly responsibilities while missing Fajr or praying it at its prescribed time. You'll find these individuals feeling low, depressed, stressed because of these bad habits, and sleeping late and not concerned to wake up for Salat al-Fajr on time or preparing for it in any way. Our beloved Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gives us an explanation in this particular hadith. A person that wakes up at the time of Fajr will feel good, energetic throughout their day. And right before sunrise, the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala receives the rizq, the sustenance. It's passed out. And along with the passing of the rizq, the sustenance, the blessings come along with it. But the one that does not wake up on time for Fajr or even pray it will not receive this blessing along with the rizq. As for the Muslims that have disciplined themselves to wake up on the prescribed time for Fajr, do very well. But if it so happens, a day comes and they miss the prescribed prayers on time, especially at Fajr time, because that's when we begin our day, they will find themselves with a constricted feeling in the chest, not knowing why. The reason for that feeling is because missing Salat al-Fajr, the morning prayers, at its prescribed time. إِنَّ الْقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرَ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. The recitation of the Quran at Fajr time is witnessed by the angels alayhim as-salam. So you can imagine what type of goodness and blessings come along with this that only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows and what He wills. you pray on its prescribed times. One of the signs of a hypocrite is that they find it very difficult to pray Salat al-Fajr and Isha on time. Some don't pray it at all, but if they happen to do it, it is very difficult for them, especially in the masjid. There's an old saying, why is the oxygen we breathe at Fajr time so fresh and clean? It's because the hypocrites weren't around to pollute it with their impurities and the impurities of their breath. The believers begin their day at the time of Fajr to, in order to keep the connection between them and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strong, and striving to become closer to Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This should be always our main concern, our sole purpose, is that we worship Allah and keep up with the commandments in the way He wants, not in the way we want. He created us, He knows what we are. We only say we hear and obey. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast and help us and assist us and guide us in holding up these priorities towards Him. الله سبحانه وتعالى أعلى وأعلم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد والحمد لله رب العالمين.
أضحى الإسلام لنا دينا وجميع الكون لنا وطنا توحيد الله لنا أعددنا الروح له سكنا أضحى الإسلام لنا دينا وجميع الكون لنا